Now I'm going to show you how to get these documents to your client to sign. So let's say we're working with the exclusive buyer tenant representation brokerage or residential brokerage agreement. You would, if you haven't already, fill in their information, you know, Jane Doe, their address at 123 Main, etc. You can literally click on these and type things in. Let's assume that we've filled all that in. You're going to hit save and close. We'll take you back to the room. You're going to then click on that box in the corner there. You would click on any other documents that you wanted to send to them at this time. And you'd go up to this menu that just formed as soon as I clicked this, up to this pen. You can see it says create envelope when I hover over it. You're going to click on that pen. Now, creating the envelope is basically creating the email that you want to send and what documents you want to send to your client. It's good practice to rename this envelope so you remember the details of, you know, who it's going to, or what the property is, because it will always auto-generate Please DocuSign. So name it something that you will be able to find and remember. It just makes it easier for you in the long run. You'll see the document here that they're going to get. You're then going to come down here to add recipients to the envelope. You're going to say pre-tagged roles, and you're going to select who you're going to click this, select who your buyer is. I'm going to select myself. Actually, I'm going to select Jane Doe, who I don't have an email for. Buyer agent, then in this case, would be me. And hit add selected. I can then put in fake email. I'm not actually going to send this. Then you would come to this. This is the message to all recipients. So both the buyer one and the buyer agent are going to receive this message. This is the subject of the email that they're going to see. So it might be helpful to change this to something like, you know, please sign documents for offer or please sign agency agreement, whatever you want it to be. Enter a message. You know, it could be these are the documents I was talking to you about. Whatever makes sense, whatever you would be saying, just to kind of fill in your client so they know what they're signing and what they're getting in this message. Once you've done that, you're going to come over here to the yellow next button. This is where you can double check signature, initial lines. If you miss something, you can add something. Okay, so again, we're assuming that I filled out most of this already. But let's say I just forgot the date. Let's say everything's filled in. I forgot the date and I want to add the date. I can come over here to this pencil where it says pre-filled tools and click on that. I can hit text. I can put this box right here and I could type in the date. Now, to do this, you would have to create a text box every time. So you can see why it's helpful to remember that before you put it in the envelope while you're still in the room to add all that. But if you do forget one thing, rather than going all the way out, this is a quick way to add something. If I go back to standards fields, which is this box right here, this is how you can add fields that you need or tags for specific people. So if you needed to have your client initial or sign somewhere, you can see up here it's blue and it says Jane Doe. This is how you would add Jane's signature or initials. If you wanted your own, this is you'd want to switch. So it's yellow and you can see my name as the agent. Then you can see these are yellow, so signature and initial. If you scroll down, the reason we pre-tag in that last step is because it will have these already added in. So you can see the yellow. This is where I would sign as the buyer's agent in this example, the authorized representative. And of course, Jane Doe is in blue. So she would sign here as the buyer and the date. Let's say you forgot to check consent for dual agency. And so you want to check that box. You can again come over to this pre-filled tool. You can see there's a checkbox option. Click that. come over here, put it right over top of that other checkbox. And then to actually check it, you can come over here to checkbox values and check that box. And you can see it's checked it on our screen here. Let's say you're working with a document where you need to remove something. Maybe there's an initial spot and it's an either or. This often comes up with selecting if you want inspections or don't want inspections, because they put both of them and they typically make them not required. So I'm going to click on this. Once you click on a specific tab, this is where you can change it. So let's say I want this to not be required. You can see right now it's required. I can uncheck it. You can see now it's white. It'll also be outlined in yellow so you know who it belongs to or who it would be tagged to. But if you found it like this and you wanted to make it required, you would then click on it again and make it required. If you wanted to remove it completely, there was something on the document and you didn't want a date or you didn't want something signed, you can again click on this, come over here, you can see delete. I can delete that. Let's say I do that and go, oh shoot, I do need that. Again, can come over to standard fields. I can switch back to my name. I can click signature. And then I can just come right over here and put it right back on there. Once this looks the way you want it to, you've filled everything in, you have the right initial or signature blocks, then you're ready to send this to your client. You're just going to hit send, and that's going to send it immediately. If you want to back out of this, save it and come back to it later. Here at actions, you can come up to actions, hit save and close. And so now it's under the envelopes tab in that room. So if you need to come back in and find it again, you could click it and open it back up.